One of the most common things we've seen is that sabotage, people will sabotage themselves. They don't even realize they're doing it by too much talking. They just, if they would only just do the correction and then just zip their lips, but it's so hard to do.
It is very hard to do.
Yeah.
I hear it all over when I go into the grocery store or see people. I see this lecturing. And
the child feels so disrespected, they almost have to do it again just to show that they're independent, strong little personalities.
Exactly.
You know? I don't think adults realize how much the child interprets that as a sign of disrespect. It weakens the kid's competency stair step.
It does. Uh-huh. It does. You can even see it sometimes in the kids, in their demeanor when they're being lectured at.
Uh-huh.
Or sometimes they'll just go.
Or even if they don't do that, they blank out. Just totally blank.
They don't hear you.
Don't pay any attention. We really don't want to go in there and do a logical consequence that might be kind of hurtful. Like, you know, we don't want to say, okay, I'm going to put your bike up in the wall for in the garage for 3 days and you can't use it. And then, it seems so harsh.
Yeah.
And so we'd much rather say, now you shouldn't be doing that with your bike. You shouldn't be leaving it behind the car because you know what's going to happen. I can't afford a new bike. It's going to get rusty.
Yeah.
I might back over it. And we go on and on about that. Instead of just putting the bike up on the wall for 3 days and then giving it back and not sabotaging yourself by lecturing.
Talking and talking
and
about
not saying,
it.
Now if you do that again, it's going to go back on the wall again for 5 days
and
next time.
And he always does it again then.
Usually.
Usually.